Today is Nityananda's, a celebration in honor of Nityananda's famous Pani Hati festival. It's a very auspicious festival because this festival shows that whether or not you're rich or poor, you can still get Nityananda Prabhu's mercy. You have to think that Raghunath Das's Goswami's father and uncle were richer than Bill Gates. That's how rich they were. Huh? Their wealth was beyond count. Huh? Raghunath Das, they wanted to control him. They wanted to make sure that he would not follow Lord Chaitanya and the path of devotion. He was the only son. They were thinking, who's going to inherit our property? Who's going to run the business? Who's going to protect the money? So they got Raghunath Das married to a virgin who was more beautiful than a heavenly demigod. He had 11 servants at all time, 4 guards to guard him, 2 Brahmin priests, 2 cooks, and 2 servants. I hope that's 11. And so that in that way, he was always surrounded by his father's employees. But still in his mind, he was thinking, I have to get away. I have to get away. He was intoxicated by Lord Chaitanya. Huh? Intoxicated just by hearing, just by seeing him. So one time, he was able to escape, and he ran to Lord Chaitanya. He said, listen, I have to serve you now. I have to serve you now. I can't stay at home any longer. Lord Chaitanya said, why are you acting like such a foolish fellow? Huh? Why are you so extreme? You have a wife. You have parents you must take care of. You need to be a sensible person. Go back to your family and live a regulated life. You worship me internally, but externally, you act like a normal grihastha. So when Mahaprabhu told him this, Raghunath Das calmed down. And he actually went back and did this. So we see later, when he had a chance to see Nityananda, he took permission from his family. His father said, yes, you may go. So he went. So as the drama just portrayed, as soon as Nityananda saw him, he called him a thief. But he didn't mean a thief that somebody who steals something. He meant, you're a thief. You have a deceptive attitude because you tried to go to Mahaprabhu directly without going through me. This is the internal meaning. He said, why would you do such a thing? So then he said, I'm going to punish you for that. So then Raghunath Das, of course, was in ecstasy. And then we all know the story. He said, feed my associates. So by this mercy that he got through Nityananda, we see soon after he was able to finally escape his home and go by the back roads to Jagannath Puri in about 11 days and get Lord Chaitanya's mercy. So we must understand that we must go through Nityananda Prabhu in all respects if we want to make advancement in Krishna consciousness. Hina nittai vina bhai, Radha Krishna paite nai. This is absolute fact. Everyone should make sure they go to Eka Chakra. Everyone should glorify Nityananda Prabhu. And this Pani Hati festival is one of his main glorifications. Because at this Pani Hati Prabhu, everyone got the mercy. There were so many people there. People were eating in the Ganges with the water up to their neck. They still had 2 pots. Everyone got 2 pots. Huh? And everybody ate till their heart's content. So I just want to give my humble obeisances to Nityananda, to his Pani Hati festival, to all the devotees who came here to celebrate it with us also. So in closing, I just want to say this is also the appearance day of another one who got Nityananda's mercy. This is Vrindavan Das Thakur's appearance day. And he also was able to get Nityananda's mercy fully. And we should try to get Nityananda's mercy also fully. Like Johnny Nivas just said, Prabhupada quoted, the sign of someone who gets Nityananda's mercy is they're always happy. They're not singing the blues. They're not humdrum. They're not glum. They're always happy. That's the sign of Nityananda. Because Nityananda represents the treasure trove of Mahaprabhu's kripa. So in this respect, That treasure trove is always open to the devotees. We always have access to it. Huh? Whether you know it or not, Nityananda has given his mercy. It was Nityananda who redeemed Jagai and Magai. Huh? Mahaprabhu came with his chakra, he was going to take their heads off at the neck. Nityananda said, no, my lord. In Dwarpa Yuga, we kill the demons. In Kali Yuga, we redeem the demons. So in this way, we know that the mercy goes through Nityananda. You should never forget this. Sometimes devotees think they can go directly to Mahaprabhu or directly to Radha Krishna. Nah. You have to go through Nityananda Prabhu. The intelligent devotees go through Nityananda Prabhu, and then you just get the red carpet all the way to Mahaprabhu. You cannot miss. So this Pani Hati festival, it will be celebrated also later in many places. Many people will make their own Pani Hati festivals with chip rice and doy and chip rice and yogurt. It's a festival that's continually going on. It's an eternal festival. Jayapataka Maharaj used to come to Atlanta every year. I remember the first year he came, we had 108 preparations. Everybody was saying, whoa, 108. Then a couple of years later, he had 1,008 preparations. And everybody was saying, whoa. I mean, Maharaj, he loved that Pani Hati festival in Atlanta. You know, the deed is very beautiful there. So.
Do you like our ad-free videos? Be sure to subscribe to our channel. We publish new videos every day, and don't forget to like and share our channel.